Hallelujah, praises to the Almighty Lord God in heaven, Moses' seed. There are many misconceptions that, whoever sits in Moses' seat will talk with God, and a servant of God and will go to heaven. So, what is this Moses' seed? We shall have a brief understanding from the Word of God, the Holy Bible. Moses was a man of God, who brought the Jewish people from Egypt to the land of Israel. He was a powerful man who spoke to God in heaven, face to face. After Moses passed of the earth, Solomon the king of Israel constructed the first man-made temple of God. In this temple he erected a place made of bronze of a specified size, where he read the Old Testament laws given by God to Moses, as you can see it in 2 Chronicles, chapter 6 verse 13, for Solomon had made a brazen scaffold, of 5 cubits long, and 5 cubits broad, and 3 cubits high, and had set it in the midst of the court, and upon it he stood, and kneeled down upon his knees before all the congregation of Israel, and spread forth his hands toward heaven. After certain period of Solomon and his generation, the temple of God was destroyed. We have already published about the temple of God destruction in the title Destruction of the Temple of God, you can see it. After the first temple was destroyed, Nehemiah the prophet of God took steps for the construction of the second temple of God. During this period, Ezra was scribe, who stood on the platform made of wood and read aloud the Old Testament law, as you can see it in Nehemiah, chapter 8 verses 4, 5, and 8. And Ezra the scribe stood upon a pulpit of wood, which they had made for the purpose, and Ezra opened the book in the sight of all the people, for he was above all the people and when he opened it, all the people stood up, so they read in the book in the law of God distinctly, and gave the sense, and caused them to understand the reading. When Lord God Yeshua Messiah visited this second temple, he observed the activities of the priest. The scribes and Pharisees they sit in this upper seat, which is termed as Moses' seat and read the law, as you can see it in Matthew, chapter 23 verse 2. Saying, the scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat, they never follow it, but they compelled others to follow it. That's why God Yeshua Messiah contempt this barbaric activity of the Pharisees and scribes, as you can see it in Matthew, chapter 23 verse 4. For they bind heavy burdens and grievous to be borne, and lay them on men's shoulders, but they themselves will not move them with one of their fingers. Later on in the 70 AD, as said by God Yeshua Messiah, the second Jewish temple of God was also destroyed by the Romans. Then the Romans took control and started to build cathedrals, where they erected a structure for proclaiming the Word of God. The same type of pulpit which in Hebrew is called as Migdal. This later on spread in other denominations. And today, you can see in any standard man-made church, they will have a place to stand and preach, which will be a tower of specified size, either made of wood or bronze or mixer of both. First it was called scaffold, then pulpit, then Moses' seat, and now as podium or pulpit. And most of the preachers in this modern world seek this podium as a top speaker in the man-made churches and functions, the same mistake which the scribes and Pharisees did, when Yeshua Messiah was in the world, as you can see it in Luke, chapter 20 verse 45. Beware of the scribes, which desire to walk in long robes, and love greetings in the markets, and the highest seats in the synagogues, and the chief rooms at feasts. Today's preachers also do the same activity, which many of their followers blindly follow. God has contempt them as in Matthew, chapter 15 verse 14. Let them alone, they be blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch. You can see here God has used a sentence, let them alone. So whoever goes against God's word, God will never consider them. He will leave them and they become blind. Moses' seat is a seat, where the Jewish priest, who sits or stands and reads the Old Testament law. This later on penetrated in Christian denominations, and many desires to show themselves and occupy the best places in the functions and man-made churches. This will prohibit them from entering the kingdom of God, because they just proclaim, but they themselves never follow as written in Matthew, chapter 23 verse 3. All therefore whatsoever they bid you observe, that observe, and do, but do not yet after their works, for they say, and do not. But if you want to really want to go to heaven, you need to accept Lord God Yeshua Messiah as your God and Savior, leave out all your sinful activities, confess your sin to an apostle, get baptism in water and get spiritual baptism, meditate on His holy words, do and live as per His holy words in New Testament, the Gospel, walk with God, watch and wait for His holy call. Amen.